guys, today we are going to start P block, okay? And in the P block, boron and carbon, we have already done in 11th standard. So here we are going to do nitrogen family, group 15. So write down the heading. Okay. So group 15, we are going to start. Group 15, we are going to start, and that is nitrogen family. Okay, nitrogen family, we also call it as these groups or these groups, the element present in this group. We also call it as nictogens. Okay. NICTOGENS. Okay, nictogens. Okay. So the elements which are present in these groups are, we have nitrogen, N, phosphorus, arsenic, antimony and bismuth. These are the elements present in this group. Okay. If you see the atomic number, nitrogen is 7. Guys, all of you mute yourself. Nitrogen has atomic number of nitrogen is 7. And then for phosphorus, it is 15 atomic number. For arsenic, it is 33, then 51, and then 83. Okay, this is the atomic number we have. So if you see the difference here, the difference that you are getting between nitrogen and phosphorus, the atomic number is here, the difference is 8. And then it is 18. And the last one is 32. These numbers, 8, 18, 18, 32, these are the magic numbers. Magic numbers. Okay. And this is true for all elements present in P block. Okay. So advantage of these numbers are what? If you know the magic number of P block element, that is 8, 18, 18, 32, you can find out the atomic number of any elements present lower in the group, down in the group, because usually we know the atomic number of the first two or three elements. Okay. Suppose if you have to find out the atomic number of bismuth, you know this present in nitrogen family. And if you know this for nitrogen, you can add 8, 18, 18, and 32, you'll get it for this one. That is the advantage of this magic number. Okay. So magic number for P block elements are 8, 18, 18, 32. Okay. Now, when you try to find out the electronic configuration of these elements, suppose I'm taking the simplest one, nitrogen, that is 7. The atomic number is 7, and hence the electronic configuration is 1s2, 2s2, and 2p3. Okay, 1s2, 2s2, and 2p3. Okay, ask me if you have any doubt. Okay, both of you can stop me anytime. Okay, 1s2, 2s2, 2p3. Correct. So this, you see, this is the outermost electronic configuration, 2s2, 2p3. Okay, since nitrogen present in second period, that's why the general electronic configuration of nitrogen is, the outermost electronic configuration of nitrogen is 2s2, 2p3. Similarly, for phosphorus, the outermost electronic configuration is 3s2, 3p3. Then 4s2, 4p3. 5s2, 5p3, like this. Okay. So if I write down the general outermost electronic configuration, outermost electronic configuration, this is for 15 group 15, it is NS2 NP3. NS2, NP3, where N is the period of that element. Okay. N is the period of that element. Correct. Now you see in the outermost shell, it has 5 electrons actually, total 5 electrons. So it needs actually 3 more electrons to gain its octet. Okay. This electron is the electron present in the outermost shell, and the number of electrons or those electrons which are present in, suppose if I take this as, this is suppose we have nth shell. The outermost shell is nth. Then penalty, then the cell which is just below this particular shell is n minus 1. Okay. So if n is the outermost shell, n minus 1th, the electron present in, the electron in n minus 1th, n minus 2, etc., are called inner electrons. Not that important, this term I am writing it down. Inner electrons. And inner electrons does not take part in any bonding. Okay, because the electrons, the interaction takes place always from the outermost electron and the other atoms. Okay, so inner electrons does not take part in bonding at all. Okay, but it plays a vital role when you have to decide the property of these elements, right? And this shell, n minus 1th, n minus 2, n minus 3, all this shell are the inner shell. Okay. The shell which is just below the outermost shell, which is n minus 1th shell, right? The shell, all these n minus 1, n minus 2, n minus 3 are the inner shell. But the cell which is just below the outermost shell, we call it as penultimate shell. This term you will see in the book. Okay, it is penultimate shell. Okay, penultimate shell. Okay, so the number of electrons present in penultimate shell, that affects the property of these elements. And all these things, whatever I'm discussing now, it is true for not only for a nitrogen family, it is true for oxygen, group 17, group 18, everything. Okay. So all those elements which has different properties, that is because of the number of electrons present in outermost shell plus penultimate shell and the size of the atoms. Okay. So this thing is a general thing that I'm discussing now. Okay. Now, if I talk about this group specifically, okay, as we go down the group, there are a few properties we need to understand here. The first property you write down, which is atomic radius. Atomic radius. Atomic radius, what happens into that? As we go down the group, atomic radius increases because the electrons are going into higher, shell. Next higher energy shell, the electrons are going into that. Okay. So that's why whenever you go down the group, the atomic radius increases of these elements. Okay. So write down here. As we go down the group, atomic radius increases. Okay. So size down the group, as you go, the size increases. Okay. That's a very important point we have. And this trend is true for all other groups also. It is true for group 16, group 17, group 18. Okay. So these properties that I'm going to discuss now, it is more or less true for all the elements, all the other groups as well. Okay. There are a few exceptions here and there that we'll discuss when we'll do the specific groups separately. Okay. So that is the one thing, but in general, you can understand this as we go down the group, and that we have already discussed in periodic table, that down the group you go, the atomic radius increases. Okay. Similarly, if I talk about the metallic nature, okay, or first we'll discuss after this, the ionization enthalpy. What is ionization enthalpy? Ionization enthalpy, I won't give you the, dictate you the in definition of this, but ionization enthalpy is what? It is the energy required to remove an electron completely from the outermost shell of an isolated gaseous atom. If you want, you can write it down. Ionization enthalpy is the energy required to remove an electron from the outermost shell of an isolated gaseous atom. Okay. So ionization enthalpy, as we go down the group, what happens then? As we go down the group, we know size increases, right? Size increases, so ionization energy decreases, okay? Because the removal of electron is easier now. So as we go down the group, ionization enthalpy decreases. Ionization enthalpy decreases. Okay. Right on the next time, which is important here, the ionization enthalpy of the elements of group 14, sorry, of the elements of group 15, P block group 15, of the elements of group 15 is higher than is higher than to that of the corresponding elements of group 14 and 16, group 14 and group 16, due to half-filled configuration. Okay. This means what? Suppose you have nitrogen, correct? And we are comparing carbon, nitrogen, and oxygen. Ionization enthalpy of carbon, nitrogen, and oxygen. So carbon, if you see, the electronic configuration, the outermost electronic configuration is 2s2, 2p3. Sorry, 2s2, 2p2. 2s2, 2p2 for carbon. For nitrogen, it is 2s2, 2p3. And for oxygen, it is 2s2, 2p4. Okay. So you see, here we have because of exactly half-filled configuration, this atom is more stable than, the configuration is more stable than that of carbon and oxygen, okay? That's why the removal of electrons from nitrogen as compared to carbon and oxygen is difficult. And when we see the ionization enthalpy of nitrogen, it is more than to that of carbon, and it is also more than to that of oxygen. And I'm talking about IE1. Means first ionization enthalpy, IE1, correct? Usually the trend is what? As we go left to right, atomic radius increases or decreases? Left to right? Decreases. Why?
Because the charge increases.
I got it. So there's a term I wanted to listen, and that is effective nuclear charge, right? Z effective. Because of effective nuclear charge, the electron is going into the same shell, right? But the proton is also increasing by one, and hence the effective nuclear charge is increasing. If the electron is going to the different higher energy shell, then that dominates the effective nuclear charge. Okay, and that's why the size increases down the group. But here the reason is left to right, if you go, as we discussed, the atomic radius decreases, correct? The reason is, write down Z effective or effective nuclear charge. That you must notice, very important, effective nuclear charge, okay? So when the size decreases, so ionization energy should increase, because when size decreases, removal of electron is difficult, right? So left to right, if you go, the ionization energy increases. The general trend is this, but since it is inorganic chemistry, so there are many exceptions into it. General trend, left to right, ionization energy decreases, but this is not true when we have this condition. That is the electronic configuration, where half filled configuration. And it is true also when we have full filled configuration. There also it is true. So here the change is this, the expected order is carbon minimum, then nitrogen, and then oxygen. Oxygen should be even higher than that of nitrogen. But here, the extra stability due to half-filled configuration makes the ionization energy of nitrogen more. Okay, that is one very important point. Okay, understood all of you? Yeah, can I go to the next page?